Guys, welcome to Gusto Reaction. And yes, of course, it's on Gusto TV. I remain the Feolua.
And I remain Big Lala.
Big Lala. Okay, no problem.
New name. They don't come out the one you give me. You gave me which one? You gave me Lala of Lagos. Yeah. There's already another Lala of Lagos. Yeah. That one's copyright.
It's copyright. Mm. Okay, no problem. Big Lala, so it's not big. It's not bad.
Not bad.
Yeah, it's not bad. Mm. So Lala, today I'm on reaction with you. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to be talking about something that recently a lot of people are beginning to ask the question, and it Wizkid, Davido, Burna Boy.
Yeah.
These three people. What we'll be discussing about them today, which of them changed the Afrobeat sound or is changing it.
Okay.
But before we go into that fully, we'll look at Fela. That's a person that's referred to like the king of Afrobeat.
Creator.
Mm-hmm. What actually made that genre? Why was his type of sound giving that Afrobeat of a name? Is there something? Is it the beats? Is it the sounds or something?
Well, it was a fusion of several sounds that were, popular in Africa back then.
Okay.
With African roots, some jazz, some house, some high life, and things like that.
Okay.
Those were the sort of sound. He was able to now infuse, take from here.
Okay.
Because, according to the history of Fela now, he went different places. He studied music before. He was supposed to be a doctor or something like that before he changed,
study
music. And then he was in the UK. And you know how jazz music was back in the day. And he was able to infuse all these things together to create what was referred to as Afrobeat in Nigeria or Africa around that period. Mm-hmm. And then there were other people who were just doing predominantly high life, or any other kind of music and things and how jazz, but he was he fused everything together and then created one sound called Afrobeat. That's why he's referred to as the creator of Afrobeat.
Okay. I've seen his children, that's Femi, Sheung, continuing that legacy, the old Shireen thing,
Fela Light,
yes. So they continued it, but later on we saw the likes of Two-Face, D'Banj, that was another generation in Nigerian music industry.
Yeah.
Did they continue the Fela type of Afrobeat?
No, to the best of my knowledge, I wouldn't say they did.
Okay.
What I think they did was, what made people like Two-Face, these other guys that you've mentioned, the kind of music they did, it was more of a African version of a foreign genre of music, which was popular, which was the hip-hop, which was the R&B. Mm-hmm. They just did their thing and added a bit of Africanness to it, because if you take your mind back to, I don't know if you remember, Two-Face and Plantation Boys, they were doing covers, they were doing songs, old songs that were popular by American artists, right?
Okay.
They were doing Nigerian versions, they were doing their own versions of the songs, and they were making it, they were owning it and adding a bit of Africanness to it. That's what they were popular for doing back then. And then it was very rampant back in the day. A lot of Nigerian artists will come, they'll do different versions of songs. You see guys like Maintain, guys like P-Square, all of them will come and do versions and sample from all these popular genres. But it wasn't particularly doing what Fela started. It wasn't.
Okay, but in the past, like one decade, and the decade was still kind of, they are continuing. We saw a new generation, that's the Wizkid, Davido, Burna Boy.
Yeah.
You saw them. So Wizkid or Davido as an artist.
Mm-hmm.
For Davido, at the moment I think he has the most sold Afrobeat song, Fall. And for Wizkid, Grammy Award, the one that just came on.
Yeah.
And we also saw Burna Boy.
Yeah.
Would you describe the type of Afrobeat they are doing as a Fela one, or the type the likes of Tubaba and D'Banj created?
Well, none of these guys are actually doing predominantly what Fela created.
Okay.
They are influenced by Fela, which they've all of them most likely admit and say. So they take parts of it. But what Fela used to do back then was what they refer to as Afrobeat, with the T, with no S.
Okay.
The rise of Wizkid, David, Burna, and the rest of this other host of stars, D'Banj, Olumaintain, and the rest of them, right? The rise of that, and who was instrumental to this is, let's say, D'Banj. When D'Banj came about and he did his own kind of music, and there was now a call about Afrobeats with the S.
Okay.
So, and what is now Afrobeat? Until today, there's a lot of commotion, arguments of what exactly is Afrobeat. People don't even want to be referred to as Afrobeat artists anymore. Mm-hmm. So, there's a clear difference between what Fela used to do and what these guys are doing. Mm-hmm. There might be some traits of what Fela used to do in what they're doing. And once in a while, they can decide to do songs that are Afrobeat. For example, Wiz featured Femi Kuti on his song, which was an Afrobeat record. Mm-hmm. There's also Burna, who once in a while can decide to do so those sort of Afrobeat songs. But in terms of their kind of music, it's Afrobeat. And what is Afrobeat? Afrobeat is a fusion of several things. Fusion of hip-hop, fusion of pop, American pop, fusion of African sounds, African drums, fusion of African genres of music like highlife. Everything is just jumbled up together. Mm-hmm. And they've decided to name it Afrobeat. So that's why you can see these guys can make different type of music and they just under one umbrella and say, oh, they're Afrobeat artists. These days, people are now starting to tell a clear difference of what is what. Some people don't want to be known as Afrobeat artists. They want to be known as Afropop artists. They're Afropop artists. If you ask them, oh, I'm a pop guy. What's pop? That's popular. Popular Afro influenced songs. There's also Afro soul. What's soul? There's soul music on its own, but it's just with a bit of African culture, African language to you. You can call yourself an Afro soul artist. There's also Afro urban. Urban is what is reigning now. You see guys like Adekunle Gold and in Burna Boy and things like that. They will call themselves different sort of names. There's also Afro house, which is the likes of Niniola. What's Afro house? There's house music, which is house music. House music, bashment music, things like that. There's just when you now add a bit of African sound to it, people now call themselves, oh, I'm awesome. Now Afro sound. Okay. So now you're even seeing a lot of all these. Is it the popular DJ came out one time? I mean, recently saying, oh, why should everybody be called an Afrobeat? Yes, so why should everybody be under the umbrella of Afrobeat artists? Mm-hmm. Everyone wants to be able to differentiate, but by the time we start doing that, we have to make sure that the African community is big enough to say, oh, that yes, so we can decide to now. But if you actually think about this thing, anybody that calls themselves an Afro soul artist, you're a soul artist, you're a soul artist, or Afro R&B or anything like that. You're an R&B artist just because you're an African and adding some parts of African culture to it. That's the major, that's the primary genre of music. We're not having now several subs of music in Nigeria and also in Africa.
Okay, so what you just said, I picked something. You said this guy is actually not doing what Fela did. And recently, we seem like we're seeing a different type of sound entirely.
Yes.
For example, Olamide's Wizkid album. Some people are like, oh, if you loved Wizkid Made in Lagos album, you will love this. And some people have argued that Made in Lagos is not an Afrobeat body of work and all of that. Is there a different sound coming out of Afrobeat? And which of these guys is creating it?
Well, I mean, that conversation you're referring to, I think started when people were like, oh, Olamide was the one who, Wizkid was the one who influenced Olamide to do this kind of album. And then people started now throwing things up and down, saying, oh, no, there was a particular Fireboy DML who came in and did a sort of the same kind of tempo album and was successful at it. So people wanted to start put it in the house, like, oh, it's from YBN and that this thing. So as we all know, FC doesn't take all these kind of things lightly now. So they start going back and forth, and both sides may have a point. The point they may have is FC can have a point if they say, oh, sounds from the other side was a template for this to be successful, or for even Fireboy or O'Malley or these other guys to be successful. They may have a point, but the problem with that is sounds from the other side was not hugely successful in Nigeria. It may have attempted to change the game or change the sound, but it didn't entirely impress a lot of people locally. The guys who now did something similar after were successful at it. People like Fireboy DML, successful at it. People like O'Malley, successful at it. Even Olamide himself on his first album was very successful using the same, almost the same kind of template. It was totally different from the kind of things we were used to as Nigerians. We used to use a lot of pop, fast-paced kind of things in Nigeria back then. But I mean, it has changed. If people are just trying to tie it down to one person and say, oh, this is the person that actually started it. It's hard to pinpoint and say, oh, this. But a lot of people have contributed to it, and I think it won't be bad if people actually share in the glory of saying, oh, together, we came together, made several songs and now several albums to change what Afrobeat is. Afrobeat is considered as in Africa or in Nigeria.
Okay, so yes, guys, That's on that note. It's a very detailed one from Big Lala. Of course, Big Lala is always proving that he's really, really big in this music thing. So yes, he believes that the glory can be shared amongst Davido, Burnaboy, Wizkid, Olamide, even Fireboy, Omalay. They are all contributing to the new sound we seem to be hearing from our Nigerian artists. But what do you guys think about that? Please tell us on the comment section and we'll be here to respond to you. Yeah, but if you're new to this channel, please click on the subscribe button and as well on the notification bell. We'll see you next time. Bye.